This is the sixth in a series of eight chemistry labs on the fundamentals of biodiesel. In this lab, we will learn about physical and chemical solubility. Written procedures and background information for all eight labs is provided on the Biodiesel Education website. Solubility is a chemical property referring to the ability for a given substance, the solute, to mix or dissolve in a solvent to form a homogeneous solution. It is measured in terms of the maximum amount of solute dissolved in a solvent at equilibrium. The solubility of sugar in water, for example, is about 2 grams per milliliter at room temperature. This is a lot considering 1 milliliter of water only weighs 1 gram. Solubility is temperature and pressure dependent. Generally, as the temperature and pressure increase, the solubility of one substance in another will increase. For example, the solubility of sugar in hot water can go up to as much as 5 grams per gram of water. A useful rule of thumb for predicting solubility is like dissolves like, meaning a solute will dissolve best in a solvent that has similar chemical characteristics. One of these characteristics is polarity. Polarity is where the electrons forming the bond in a molecule are not equally distributed, causing a molecule to have a slight electrical charge. Some molecules are both polar and nonpolar. Soap, for example, is a long molecule that has a polar head and a nonpolar tail, allowing it to dissolve in both water and oil. As you may know, this makes it useful for cleaning nonpolar oil and grease off your hands with polar water. When a solute in a solvent forms a solution, it is called dissolution. A chemical can be formed through dissolution, but it can also be formed because of a chemical reaction. This is what distinguishes physical solubility, as in the sugar water example, and chemical solubility. The process of making biodiesel gives us several examples of chemical solubility. The biodiesel reaction between methanol and triglycerides goes through different stages of solubility between the reactants and the products of reaction. Initially, methanol is not soluble in oil. However, as the reaction begins and methyl esters are formed, the methyl esters act as a co-solvent to allow the methanol and oil to become soluble in each other. As the reaction progresses, free glycerol is produced, which is not soluble in the methyl esters. In this laboratory exercise, we will be analyzing the solubility of potassium nitrate in water at different temperatures. To conduct the exercise, you will need a Bunsen burner, ring stand, ring and wire gauze, a 250 milliliter beaker, 4 20 milliliter test tubes, a tube holder and rack, thermometers, graduated cylinder, a marker for labeling test tubes, glass stirring rod, and a weighing scale. For reagent, you will need 20 grams of potassium nitrate. The first step is to number 4 test tubes and place them in a rack. Weigh potassium nitrate and water into the 4 tubes as indicated in this table. Prepare a water bath by filling a 250 milliliter beaker 3/4 full of water. Place the beaker on the ring stand and heat to 90 degrees Celsius. Place a thermometer and the test tubes in the water bath and stir each test tube with a glass stir rod until the potassium nitrate is dissolved. Take one test tube out of the bath along with a thermometer and observe the first sign of crystallization as it cools. Record the temperature in table. Repeat this with the 3 other test tubes. Now you are going to use the information you discovered to draw a solubility versus temperature curve. The y-axis solubility is often expressed in grams of solute per 100 milliliters of water, and you will need to convert your data into grams of potassium nitrate per 100 milliliters of water. Since there are 5 milliliters of water in each tube, you can multiply the grams of potassium nitrate by 20. Next, plot your data and draw the solubility curve for potassium nitrate versus temperature. With this plot, we know the solubility of potassium nitrate in water at different temperatures. Thank you for watching the Physical and Chemical Solubility Lab on the Fundamentals of Biodiesel. please go to the Biodiesel Education website for a complete written transcript of this lab exercise.